What happens to the body when we do the Wim Hof Method breathing? So in this video, I break down the effect of the Wim Hof Method breathing on our body and immune system and give you insights and tools how you can deepen your practice. Ever since I discovered Wim and his method about 7 years ago, I have felt more focused, energized and calmer. And combined with the cold showers and ice baths, I wasn't getting sick anymore. And I was generally more resilient to stress, which improved my overall happiness. I knew there were scientific studies with Wim and his method, but I never truly understood its depth. To me, the papers and studies were a form of credibility. But it wasn't until I took the journey to become a Wim Hof Method instructor that I would understand the great implications of the science for my own practice. With every breath we take, we transport oxygen to every cell in our body, which is used to generate energy. Countless mechanisms in our body happen automatically, like our heartbeat or our breathing. So these functions that keep us alive but never need to think about it is controlled by a part of our nervous system that is called the autonomic nervous system. And within our autonomic nervous system, we have two antagonistic sets of nerves. The sympathetic nervous system, which is associated with our stress system and a so-called fight and flight response. And the other set is our parasympathetic nervous system, which is responsible for recovery, rest, relaxation, and digestion. When we look at these images, they can trigger something in us. Some of them may trigger fear, others a sense of calmness. My point here is that external factors have an influence on us, whether we like it or not. And our autonomic nervous system triggers a response that helps us survive. If we perceive something as stressful or dangerous, our sympathetic nervous system kicks in. Stress hormones like epinephrine and cortisol are released, which fastens our heartbeat, releasing more glucose into the bloodstream, enabling us to have more energy, rerouting our bloodstream to our outer extremities and many other things that gear our body for action. Our bodies need also to recover and rest. Otherwise, we suffer from negative health and mental consequences. And this is where the other set of nerve nodes come in place, the parasympathetic nervous system. Think of P as peace or pause. It does things like stimulating the activity of the intestines, slowing down our heart rate, and constricting our pupils and airways, etc. For a long time, it was regarded that we cannot voluntarily influence our autonomic nervous system. But it turns out that our breathing can serve as a gateway to consciously influence our autonomic nervous system. So our breathing pattern not only reflects our energetic state, so whether we're leaning more into the sympathetic or the parasympathetic side, but it's also a two-way street to influence the one or the other consciously. And the way this works is that we have neurons in our heart that measure the blood speeds through the heart. And when we inhale, the diaphragm contracts and extends the lungs. This process creates space and makes our heart a tiny bit bigger. And when the volume expands, the speed of the blood that runs through the heart decreases. So these neurons in the heart sense that and send a signal to the brain to increase the heart rate by engaging the sympathetic nervous system. And the same happens the other way around when we exhale. Usually the inhales and exhales balance each other out and we take about 15 healthy breaths per minute. But if we emphasize strong and fast inhales with a short exhale where we let the air escape from our lungs, we continuously engage our sympathetic nervous system. And by doing so, we can change our state dramatically. Let's talk about our immune system and how the Wim Hof Method breathing can influence it. People tend to say that the Wim Hof Method breathing can improve our immune system. Well, technically, that's not quite correct. It ramps up one aspect of our immune system, but it downregulates another one. Let me explain. To put it simply, our immune system contains two lines of defense. The first line is our innate immune system. The innate immune system will first kick in to fight bacteria and pathogens by rising body temperature, increasing inflammation, etc. And then we have the adaptive immune system, the second line of defense with white blood cells, which are necessary to develop immunity against those pathogens. So by doing the Wim Hof Method breathing, we engage the sympathetic nervous system. And by doing so, we release a great amount of epinephrine. And subsequently, we downregulate our innate immune system by reducing inflammation. And at the same time, we increase the amount of leukocytes, white blood cells, which help our body to fight infections and diseases. This was shown in a 2014 study by Radboud University, where they took a group and injected them with endotoxin, bits of dead bacteria, which normally causes a strong response from the innate immune system with fever, nausea, headache, and other flu-like symptoms. The intervention group who were trained in the Wim Hof Method and did the breathwork could voluntarily downregulate the innate immune system and only experienced mild symptoms. This has great implications for further studies, especially with people who suffer from autoimmune diseases with persistent and excessive inflammation. But it also means that we can alleviate pain and discomfort caused by an excess of inflammation, like a headache, fever, and so on. And at the same time, we increase white blood cells, which help us to not get sick in the first place. In the same study, it was shown that people could raise their epinephrine level, which is basically the same as adrenaline, by more than 200%. To put this in perspective, that's more than someone who goes bungee jumping for the first time. Additionally, with the breathwork, we raise our blood oxygen level to 100%. It's already pretty high at 98% typically, but so it's not by a big margin. But interestingly, we're offloading a lot of carbon dioxide. And we feel that by getting lightheaded or feel a tingling sensation in our fingers or toes as our blood pH level rises and our blood gets more alkaline. When we move to the next phase of the Wim Hof Method breathing protocol, we hold our breaths after the last exhale. As we know now, the exhale and then the hold will engage the parasympathetic nervous system and we enter this deep meditative state. Our oxygen level drops when we stop breathing. At the same time, our carbon dioxide level will increase. What many people don't know is that our gasping reflex, our stimulus to breathe, is caused by a certain level of carbon dioxide in our blood. It's not caused by low oxygen level. As a side effect, we can hold our breath much longer as we offload a lot of carbon dioxide with rapid breathing. So it takes longer for the carbon dioxide to reach the threshold that triggers the gasping reflex. So with each round, we are offloading more and more carbon dioxide, leading to ever-decreasing oxygen levels where it can fall below 40% for a very short time. As it's only for a short time, it's not dangerous when we do the breathwork in a safe environment. If the blood oxygen gets too low, we fall into unconsciousness, which triggers the gasping reflex. It's like a reset of our body. And this is exactly the reason why you should never do the breathwork in water. Now you understand why you shift into unconsciousness without feeling the urge to breathe. You don't feel it coming because blood dioxide level are still too low to trigger the gasping reflex or the stimulus, the urge to breathe. Short-term low blood oxygen levels or hypoxia stimulates the creation of new red blood cells, enabling our body to carry more oxygen. It's the same effect as athletes who are doing high altitude training. So by understanding the physiology of the Wim Hof Method breathing and the science behind it, I now can improve my practice. By engaging both branches of our autonomic nervous system, we get into this very energized and focused state, which is the effect of engaging the sympathetic nervous system, and yet feel very calm and grounded, which is the effect of engaging the parasympathetic nervous system. So it's the best of both worlds. So when it comes to my breathwork practice, I basically have only two dials which I can turn up and down according to my desired outcome. So on one side I have the deep, rapid breathing, and on the other side I have the breath retention. So for instance, if I want to increase my overall breathing experience, I need to engage both sides more strongly. And I can do that by making the rapid, deep breathing more intense and the breath holds more relaxed and go into a deeper meditative state. There are also examples where I want to be calm and relaxed rather than energized. So doing the breathwork before bed or after work would be an example for this scenario. Also, if you tend to get anxious more quickly or feel constantly stressed would be another example. Then I would dial down the rapid breathing part by slowing down a little. I would still inhale fully and deeply, but would do it a little slower. So how can this knowledge help me if I want to influence my state or emotional or energetic state, but I don't have the time to do a 20 or 30 minutes breathwork session? There is actually a very simple solution to this. Then I would just do one or the other part of the breathing. So as an example, another part of the Wim Hof Method is cold exposure. And when you go into an ice bath, we engage in a slow and calm breathing pattern to engage our parasympathetic nervous system to battle against that sympathetic response from the ice cold water. So I can now use this knowledge of the breathing physiology for adaptive situations. So I can calm myself down by a slow breathing, and I do that by having a longer exhale than inhale. Or another science-based method would be something called the physiological sigh, where you have a short double inhale and a very long exhale. Small kids and babies do this automatically to calm themselves down after they have cried. And when I need to increase my energy, focus and alertness very quickly, I do about 15 rapid and deep inhales. So the first part of the Wim Hof Method. And I use this very frequently when I lack motivation or when I do my strength training. In one of my next videos, which should appear around here, I will talk about cold exposure and what it does to our bodies and minds. So if you learned something from this video, please hit the like button, and thank you for watching, and see you in one of my next videos. Bye.